Hello everyone. Amazon Security Lake is a security service that automates the sourcing, aggregation, normalization, enrichment, and data management of security-related data across an entire organization into a security data lake. This makes the data broadly accessible to customers and security analytics solutions to power use cases such as threat detection, investigation, and incident response. Today, I will show you how you can configure Splunk as a subscriber to query the log data. On the consumption and data access side, Security Lake helps you selectively share your data with your analytics solution of choice. You simply select the data you want to share, the subscriber you want to share it with, and Security Lake manages for you the data pipeline and permissions required to make it happen. In a few clicks, you can enable data integrations that either require you to send new data as it arrives or simply provide query access to your data, so it doesn't have to move around. For example, to support on-demand analysis of large volume sources like Amazon VPC flow logs for a security investigation. You can decide to use your data with AWS analytics solutions such as Amazon Athena or Amazon SageMaker. We've also partnered with companies across the security industry to make it easy for you to use their solutions with your data, so your security teams can continue to use the interfaces and workflows they are familiar if they choose so. I will demonstrate how you can integrate Splunk with Security Lake to query security log data in your IT environment. In the demo, I will use Splunk add-on for Security Lake published on Splunkbase to configure integration with Security Lake. I will start with creating a subscriber for Splunk in Security Lake and then connecting the subscriber as a new input in Splunk Web. Splunk Web is the primary interface that you use to run investigations, build reports, and administer Splunk deployments. Navigate to the Security Lake console. Using the left-hand panel, select Subscribers. You can see the configuration of all subscribers in your environment listed here. To configure a subscriber, select Create Subscriber. Because we are configuring a subscriber for Splunk, I will name the subscriber to reflect the same. Add a small description, and then configure the log and event sources I would want to query using Splunk. As I mentioned earlier, there are two ways to query the log data in Security Lake, either as data access, where the data is ingested by the third-party solution, or as query access, where data is queried in place in the Security Lake. Splunk supports data access method, which is configured by selecting S3 for data access method. As a security best practice, it is important to use account-level isolation and set up Splunk solution in an account other than the account with the security data lake. For more details on security best practices, please look up the AWS Security Reference Architecture white paper. Add an external ID to configure secure access to the data through AWS Identity and Access Management Service, avoiding the confused deputy problem. According to the Splunk documentation, on configuring the security lake subscriber, the notification settings should be set to SQSQ. Select Create. This should create the subscriber configuration in Security Lake for you. Navigate to the Amazon Simple Queue Service or Amazon SQS to verify the subscription endpoint. Now that the subscriber has been configured at the Security Lake end, you need to modify IAM policies to make the Amazon Security Lake add-on work. Refer to the Splunk add-on for AWS documentation. Once you have configured the IAM policies, navigate to the Splunk web homepage and configure a Splunk add-on for AWS. Depending on the type of Splunk deployment, configure the AWS account setting for your Splunk deployment. Now that you have configured the Splunk add-on for AWS, you can query the log data coming through to Splunk from Security Lake. In this demo, I have shown you how you can configure the Splunk add-on for Security Lake to query data through Splunk. It is important to configure least privilege when configuring the integration, and please refer to the Splunk and AWS documentations for examples of configuring restrictive IAM policies. There are many different partners that you can choose to integrate with Security Lake, so make sure you consult the Amazon Security Lake documentation to configure integration with partner solutions. Thank you for your time today.